Nudged presents The Emerald Dragon by Abie Longstaff. Narrated by Dan Bottomley. Chapter 1. A dark storm cloud covered the kingdom of Arthwen, thick and menacing. Down it sank, past the peak of peril, covering the sky cats and fluff griffins. Lower and lower it fell, filling Moonlight Meadow and scaring the twilight unicorns into hiding. It dropped until it smothered the grass, and every plant, every living creature was sucked into its blackness. Tibben sat bolt upright in his little bed at the top of the tree. His heart was thudding. He ran to the window and looked out. There below him the land was still and clear, and the sun was rising in the hazy sky. Tibben slumped down in relief. It was just a nightmare. He breathed in and out to calm himself. Slowly his heart rate returned to normal, but he couldn't shake the funny feeling that something was unsettled, something was off balance. As Tibben pulled on his cloak, his five glints sparkled in the morning light. Glints were the magical sign of potion skill. Grandpa's cloak was covered in them. As potions master, Grandpa had helped the creatures of Arthwen for many, many years. But last week, Grandpa had turned 100 years old. Soon it would be time for him to retire. Then Tibben, the potion's apprentice, would take the master's challenge to become a potions master himself. Tibben knocked on the door to Grandpa's room. As it swung open, the first thing he saw was Grandpa, wearing a plain brown cloak. Tibben gasped. Grandpa's cloak had stopped sparkling. All the glints had disappeared. "Your glints!" he cried.
"Yes," said the old pixie softly. "I'm no longer the potion's master."
Tibben looked at him in panic. "But wait! No!" he cried. "I haven't taken the master's challenge. I don't even know what I have to do."
"Tibben, it's okay," said Grandpa. "Someone will bring the scroll soon, and it will set out the challenge for you. When it comes, you need to think calmly and clearly, but also quickly."
Tibben's eyes widened.
"Remember, Tibben, in Arthwen there are two energies at work."
He nodded. Grandpa had told him this many times.
"One is harmony,"
Grandpa continued,
"and the other is blight."
Tibben shivered. He knew what blight felt like. Blight was a thick cloud of sadness and emptiness. Grandpa took his hand.
"The gap between potions masters is the most dangerous time for Arthwen."
He looked at Tibben closely.
"Where there is a gap, blight will fill it."
Tibben stared back.
"This blight will be worse than anything you have ever felt before,"
his teacher said in a low voice.
"It will fall on Arthwen like a dark cloud. You must pass the challenge as quickly as you can, Tibben."
Tibben trembled as he remembered his nightmare.
"I know you can do it,"
Grandpa squeezed his hand.
"And I will be waiting for you in the Vale of Years."
A ball of white fluff came bouncing in. It was Wiz. Wiz lived above the potion shop with Grandpa and Tibben. She was a gatherer, someone with a special talent for finding potions ingredients. Wiz's blue eyes grew wide at the sight of Grandpa's cloak.
"Glint Gonweet!" she cried.
Grandpa hugged her and smiled.
"And it's time for me to go too,"
he told her.
"Goodbye, little Wiz."
There was a rustle outside Grandpa's window, and an enormous face appeared, filling the window frame. It was Crag, the quarry troll. He was as tall as the potions tree. His huge eyes twinkled hello.
"Ah, Crag," said Grandpa. "Thank you for offering to give me a lift."
Crag smiled and held out his massive finger. Grandpa climbed on and was lifted up to the troll's shoulder.
"Good luck,"
he called.
"Keep calm, Tibben. Don't panic. Read the recipes carefully. Think of what will help harmony."
Grandpa's voice grew fainter as he was carried away through Steady Song Forest towards the Vale of Years. Chapter 2. The blue bell of the potion shop jangled, and Tibben's heart jumped. Could that be someone bringing the master's challenge? He raced downstairs and opened the door.
"Good morning, Tibben," said a low voice.
It was Kenta, one of the centaurs from Moonlight Meadow. She galloped into the shop, her sharp hooves clattering on the wooden floor.
"Hello, Woos," said Wiz.
Tibben's heart slowed down. It was just a customer. Of course, the potion shop had to carry on as usual.
"How can we help?"
he asked.
"My flute doesn't sound right."
Kenta lifted a long silver object to her lips and blew. A strange-sounding note came out. She flicked her tail crossly.
"You see?" she said.
"Hmm," said Tibben. He opened the book of potions and turned to Sweet Tune Potion. Effect: makes beautiful music. Ingredients: light puff, true scale, blue air. Wiz jumped up right away to fetch the ingredients, bouncing up and down the shelves until she had laid everything out on the wooden counter. Tibben felt nervous. It was strange making potions without Grandpa in the shop. He pounded the true scale in his mage nut bowl and added the wisps of light puff. He broke open a husk containing blue air, and it floated over the bowl like a mist. Tibben tried to stir the potion. "Hmm," he said. He couldn't get the ingredients to blend properly. They were so light and airy. Tibben thought for a moment, just as Grandpa had taught him, and added a drop of water. The blue air immediately settled into the bowl, and the mixture formed a bright blue liquid.
"That's it,"
Tibben smiled. He painted the flute with blue potion. To his surprise, it flipped into the air. Then it flopped onto the counter.
"What?"
Tibben frowned. He watched in amazement as the flute grew a tail.
"Fishwheeze,"
said Wiz, and Tibben nodded, puzzled. Now the flute really did look like a long fish. Wiz picked it up and put it in the fish tank above the counter. The flute swam about happily amongst the floating cloud lotus.
I'm sorry, said Tibben. I don't know what happened.
But he looked round to find Kenta laughing.
I've never seen a flute swim before, she chuckled.
Tibben returned to the book of potions. Underneath the recipe, he spotted something. It said, when combined with liquid, this potion makes fishtail brew for swimming and breathing underwater. Lasts for 5 minutes.
Oops, said Tibben. Let's wait 5 minutes, then I'll try again.
Kenta giggled as the happy flute fish did backstroke in the fish tank. Chapter 3. Tibben and Wiz were busy for the rest of the morning. The shop was full of customers coming in for potions. Tibben had never seen it so hectic. There was a restlessness in the air, and everyone looked worried. After lunch, the door opened for what seemed like the 100th time. Tibben gasped. There before him was a very special bird with flaming feathers of orange and yellow and red.
Seraphin? Asked Tibben. Is that you?
He couldn't believe his eyes. The firebird was tiny. Last time he saw her, she'd been enormous.
It's me, Seraphin said in a soft voice.
Tibben gazed at her in amazement. Seraphin was one of the special creatures of Arthwin. She brought warmth and energy to the kingdom. Every 100 years, she built a special nest, filled it with magic fire, and let the flames turn her back into an egg. Then she hatched out as a new firebird and started her life all over again. The little firebird hopped across the wooden floor of the shop.
Tibben, she said solemnly, I have brought the master's challenge.
Tibben's heart leaped. Seraphin reached under her wing and handed him a scroll of silent bark. Slowly, Tibben unrolled it. Potions apprentice, you must undertake the master's challenge to prove you are worthy of the honor of being a potions master.
You may ask for help.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.